So this AI-powered photo editor can do almost anything, from generating images to skin retouching, color grading, and more. Okay, let me just show you. So let me just start with the Pixlr Express here. So now we are in Express. So what I can do from here, I can just load an image from here, or I can just generate an image from here. Let me just click on AI image generator here. From here, I can type what I want. So I'm just going to click on the command prompt here, or I can import an image from here, like a reference image. Let me just select this image like this. I want an image that is tall, and then style, none here, and then here, warm tone, and then light. I'm just going to select maybe dramatic light, and then here, bright background, like this. And then I'm going to type portrait of a black young woman, like that. And then just going to click generate here. So I'm just going to wait for it to generate an image for me. So it's going to generate four images. Let's just move down here. So this is what we have now. I love how it's able to get the tone of this image and then generate it to these images. So if I don't like this, I can just click on generate here, and then it's going to generate more images for me. If I want, I can just maybe edit this image or remix it, or I can download it if I want. So if you want to try this out, I'll put the link in the video description below. What you can do from here is just to sign up here, or you can try premium here for 7 days. If you like it, you can pay for it. Let me just close this. Let's try another one. Let me just go up here. Let me just select this image. I'll use the same command prompt here, and then I'll just click on generate here. Okay, so this is what I got. Wow. I love how it's able to to pick the theme of this image and be able to give me these images. They are not perfect. So this is just one of the things you can do in Pixlr here. So let me just go back here. So this time I'm not going to generate the images. Let me just click here, and then let me just import this image of a beautiful bride. Let's just select original here, and then let me just click on apply here. So here we have arrange, here we have the crop tool. If I want to to crop this image, I can crop it from here. And then here we have the cut. If I want to cut this image, I can do it from here. And then here we have adjustments. If I want to color grade this image, I can do it from here. I'll show you how to color grade in Pixlr in a bit. Let me just show you my favorite feature here before we move to color grade. Let me just go to effect here. Here, if I want to to change this image to black and white, I can just maybe click here, and then I can pick any tone that I want to apply to this image. Let's say I want it to look like this. I can just give it this look. Let me just undo here. I'm going to go on filter here. So if I want to change this image to HDR, I can just click here, but I don't want to do that. So if I want to add the blur to the background, I can just do it from here, but the background is already out of focus. Let's just move down here. And then we have dispersion here. Let me just click on it. Let me just show you. I'm going to make my brush a little bit bigger, and then I'll just paint here, and then I'm going to let go. So it's going to add this effect here. If I want, I can change the shape of this effect. I can use maybe this, and then I can just scale it to make it a little bit bigger. Or maybe the amount, I can take it down like that. Maybe stretch, I can take it down like that. Yeah, you get the idea. The link will be in the description below to where you can try this out by yourself. So let me just cancel this. Let me just move down here. If I want to add the glitch effect to this, I can just click on the glitch. I can just click on random glitches here like that. So let me just undo this. I'm just going to click on like this. Okay, let me just go to my favorite, the AI tools here. Let me just click on it. And then I'm going to move down here. Let me just click on backdrop here. So on the backdrop here, I have different options here. If I want, I can click on this. If I want, I can select the blur here, zoom effect. I can select this one if I want. I can select this one if I want. Or I can select this one if I want, or this one. So if I don't want to use these effects, I can just go on generate here. And then I can type what I want here, like church. Let me just click on generate here. So this is what we have now. I love this. I'm going to keep this. I'm just going to click on apply. I'm going to go to AI tools here. And then I'm going to move down here. What else can I do from here? This photo is fine. There's no, we don't have noise in this image. We don't need to sharpen it. It's okay the way it is. Let me just select the generative fill here. And then I'm going to select this tool. Just going to make a selection here. And then I'm just going to type what I want to add here. So I'm going to type wedding crown. And then I'm going to click generate here. So I'm going to wait for it to generate a wedding crown for my model. So this is what I got. So if I don't like this, I can just click on repeat here. And then it's going to repeat the process, but it's going to give me a different crown here. So I'm just going to keep it for the sake of this video. Now let me show you how to color grade in Pixlr. Let's just go back here. So I'm going to click on open image here. And then I'm going to select this image. I'm just going to click on new. And then I'm going to click on original here and then apply here. Now let me show you how you can use the adjustment panel. Let me just left click on it like this. If I want to add vibrance to this image, I can just drag this like that. If I want to add saturation or remove saturation, I can just remove it by dragging this slider. Like, I think this is okay. And then I'm going to go to temperature here. I'm going to take it maybe this, then tint, take it maybe down here. Like maybe -5, the U can just maybe leave it at 0. Just going to type 0 here. Then I'm going to go down here. We have the brightness. If I want to add brightness to this image, I can just use this. I'm going to reset it. And then if I want to add the exposure, I can just use this slider. If I want to add the contrast, I can just use this slider here. If I want to add the blacks to this image, I can use this slider here, but I'm going to just leave it like this. So from here, if I want to add the whites, you can just use this slider. If I want to add the highlights or remove the highlights, you can just use this slider. Let me just take it to maybe -5, and then I'm going to add a little bit of the shadows, -5. I'm going to add the sharpness, 5. And then I'm just going to leave these the way they are. And then down here we have the vignette. If I want to add the vignette to this image, I can take it maybe somewhere here. Diaz, let me just take it to maybe 5. And then broom, I'm going to reset this. I'm just going to type 0 here. Okay, so the vignette, I'm going to take it down. I think that's too much. 10%, I think 10 is okay. And then this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. How cool is this? I think I'm okay with this. Let me just click on apply here. I'm just going to click on save here. I'm just going to take it to 100%. And then I'm just going to click on save here. I'm going to save it on my desktop. And then I'm just going to click save here. So the photo is saved on my desktop. Let's just go back here. Let me just click on open here. Let me just select this image. Let me just click on new, original. And then I'm going to click on apply here. And then from here, I'm going to select effects here. On top here we have the black and white effects. Let's say I want to use this effect, I can just click on it, and then I can reduce the opacity of this. Let's say I like this, I can just click on it. Let me just go back here. Let's try friends here. Then we have these. How cool is this? I love this. Let me just move to this. Wow, I love this. We have so many effects here. I think, let me just see, I love this. Let's see if I can reduce it just a little bit like this. So this panel here, the effects, you can use it to color grade your images. If you don't want to like to go through this color grading process, you can just use this effect panel to color grade your images. So let me just close this. I love this. I can just click on save here to save my image. Here I'm going to take it to 100%, and then I'm just going to click on save. I'm going to select desktop. And then I'm going to click on save here. My photo is saved on my desktop. So there are so many things you can do here. I can't show you everything in one video. So I'll put the link in the video description below to where you can find this and experiment with your photos. So if you want to learn how to get the perfect skin tones, you should check this video here.